Hey everybody, this is Dawn Landis coming to you live from my backyard, and thank you to Music City Roots for having me, and I hope you guys enjoy some songs and some outdoor noises. It's twilight, so who knows what sounds we're gonna hear, but hopefully some good ones that match the songs. Here's a song of mine called Bluebird. Off my album called Bluebird, and I got to play that on a stage with a full band at a Music City Roots event, and that was really fun. And the reason I'm here today is because I've got a new album out. It's called Row, and it's songs from a musical that I've been writing based on a true story about the first woman and the first American to row solo across the Atlantic Ocean in 1999. And she's a woman named Tori Merton McClure, and she's from my hometown of Louisville, Kentucky. And it's a fascinating story, and I hope you'll check it out. The album's called Row, and I'm going to play you some songs from that right now. This one is called Mount Everest, and it takes place sort of at the beginning of the story, and Tori is doing her first attempt. She's attempting to row to France from North Carolina, and there's no motor or no sail, and nobody's trailing her. She's alone on a boat in the ocean, and she sings this song after all of the fanfare of her departure and all of the cheers of the crowd, her fading into the distance, and she sings this song. Why would you climb Mount Everest? Why would you row the sea? Why would I climb Mount Everest? 'Cause it's in front of me. Ask me, oh ask me, dear inquisitor, what is it you don't see? Why would I climb Mount Everest? Because it's there for me. Ask me, oh ask me, dear inquisitor, why put myself through all the pain? My answer, oh inquisitor, will always be the same. It's not about going from point A to point B, through solitude and all the uncertainty. I'll confront my dreams and come out clean. Why would an acorn strive so hard just to become a tree? Slip into my rowboat now and soon, see what becomes of me. I watch the seagulls and turns all head back to the coast. The one who's flying the highest can see the most. I wanna know what he knows. It's not about going from point A to point B, through and all the uncertainty. I'll confront my demons before they get to me. So that one's called Mount Everest. I'm playing another one from the Row album and musical. And actually, we were supposed to have our premiere of the musical this summer, but the pandemic, of course, changed everything. And but we're recording a theatrical version for Audible, so you'll be able to hear it with a bunch of actors and an orchestra and everything sometime next year. But for now, I'd like to play you the song. This is one of my favorites from the show. It's called The Theology of Adventure, and Tori, the rower, not only did she row across the ocean, she also skied to the South Pole and climbed many mountains and got her Master's in Divinity from Harvard, and in the show, she's defending her thesis, and her thesis is called The Theology of Adventure, and kind of goes like this. I've been to Timbuktu, scaled mountains in the rain. 100 miles I walked the Serengeti Plain. I sat with tribal healers and I learned my spirit name. High in the mountains of the great Alaska Range, I felt felt a sense of awe coming of age. I learned to mountaineer across Mount McKinley's glacial face. Some would say I'm lacking sense. In my defense, the unexamined life is not worth living. In my defense, to learn about take my leave to join the South Pole expedition where I skied 750 miles in minus 40 degrees. The sheer audacity of this might make you smile. Harvard Divinity field study in the wild. You can't fly a feather bed down wisdom's lonely aisle. Hard lessons learned is recompense. In my defense, the unexamined life is not worth living. In my defense, the quest for meaning might be never ending. I've known failure and success. It's so much sweeter on the summit as a shared experience. Out on the streets or in the wild, life is perilous. There's no you can rely on, so just try to keep your eye on my defense. Yeah. All right. It's crazy. Every single thing in that song is true. Amazing. All the lives people can lead. So I guess Tori the rower is sort of a hero of mine and another hero of mine and many musicians around the world is the great Dolly Parton. So I feel like singing one of her songs for you now, and this is one that I actually sang in a Dolly Parton competition. It wasn't a competition to appear like Dolly Parton. It was a celebration of her songs, of which there are many. And I went to Sevierville and entered the competition with this song. And this is one that she sang with Chet Atkins, which I just love. So hope you love it too. But longer than always. Do do do. I will love you longer than always, longer than always. I love you longer than always and forever. Love you honest, love you true. You have been my inspiration, guiding light and sweetest friend. Longer than always and forever, with a love that has no end. I will love you longer than always, longer than always, longer than always. There's no need for you to harbor fear or doubt or jealousy, 'cause there ain't nothing in this whole world that I love as much as thee. I am there for the duration, through the laughter, through the tears, seeing through all life situations, through the passing of the years. I will love you longer than always, longer than always, longer than always. When the world has turned the last time, will it all just turn to dust? You can always turn to me, pure gold will never rust. I will love you longer than always, longer than always. I love you longer than always and forever. Love you honest, love you true. Woo, do 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 do. Do 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 Yeah, in the quarantine times, I've been really lucky to have this yard and to be able to spend a lot of time outside. And the weather's getting colder, but I'm hanging on, hanging on through the fall. So I hope wherever you are that there's some beautiful trees out there. All right, here's a little song from my previous record called Meet Me at the River. And I recorded that one in Nashville with the late, great Fred Foster. And it was a real honor to get to work with him as a producer. And I learned so much from him. And I pretty much moved to Nashville to work with him because I was living in New York at the time. And his health was sort of up and down. And he said, just come over, come to my house, and we'll work on the songs. And so this next song, the one I'm going to play you now, this is the one that I think convinced him that I was a songwriter. When I first approached him, I think he thought that I was coming to him to try to find me some songs. And I said, oh no, Fred, I want to write the songs. And I brought him many, many songs, and it was this one, I think, that won him over. So this one's for you, Fred. Do where will I go? Only the moon and stars can know. When will it be? Hopefully soon. What will I do? When will I know the time is right? What if I misread the signs, or they don't come through? What will I do? How will I know which way to turn? I want every star that burns to fall into line. Point me to my next move. But I can get lost. It's happened before. Spend a year or two off course, it'd be nothing new. Ooh, 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 what will I do? How will I know which way to turn? I want every star that burns to fall into line. Point me to my next move. Now that I here's another one from that record, it's called Keep On Moving. There was a man who walked to California. He did grow his hair so long. There was a man who walked to California, singing a song, singing a song. A woman walked 1,000 miles. keep on moving, keep on. Gonna keep on moving, keep on moving, keep on. There was a one they called the Peace Pilgrim. She did walk her whole life long. Everybody be a Peace Pilgrim, singing a song, singing a song for justice. We walk for peace, we walk for freedom from disease. We walk for heartbreak, we walk for love and for our brothers and our sisters above. Another one for that record. This is a song actually that Fred Foster introduced me to. He introduced me to so much great music. If you're not familiar with the man, please check out all of the Monument Records catalog. It's just incredible. All the first Dolly Parton record, there's all the beautiful Roy Orbison songs and Kris Kristofferson. There's also incredible writer Jimmy Driftwood that Fred introduced me to, and I ended up covering two of his songs on my record with Fred. And this is one of them. Fred actually told me the story behind this song, which was pretty fascinating. Can't remember the year, but Jimmy Driftwood is a musician from Arkansas, and he knew that they were gonna have the first African-American vote sometime in the 60s, and he wanted to be there to witness it. He thought it was gonna be such a landmark event, and so he drove to Alabama and packed a lunch, and as was told to me by Fred, sat there and waited, and there was a whole line of people in line to vote, and they never opened the door, and none of the people stood there for hours, and they never got a chance to vote, and it was pretty upsetting. And Jimmy sat under a tree, and as legend goes, ate his lunch and then wrote this song, which I think is relevant today. Okay, here we go. Tell me if you can, what is the color of the soul of a man? Black or yellow, white or tan, what is the color of the soul of a man? My grandma said I was a silly goose when there ain't no use. I cannot tell you the reason why, but I'll keep asking till I die. Tell me if you can, what is the color of the soul of a man? Black or yellow, white or tan, what is the color of the soul of a man? A snow white maid, and all our kids were a copper shade. It troubles me both day and night. Will the children's souls be red or white? Tell me if you can, what is the color of the soul of a man? Black or yellow, white or tan, what is the color of the soul of a man? The spirits high. I looked and looked up in the skies, but I don't have those kind of eyes. Tell me if you can, what is the color of the soul of a man? Black or yellow, white or man, soul of a man. Jimmy Driftwood. Fred also told me that Jimmy made his guitar out of a fence post. Pretty cool. All right, here's a song of mine about traveling down south. Sort about learning how to two-step. All right, well, let's see. I'm gonna do just two more for you. This next one is a song that I wrote, let's see, for my daughter. She's just turned three. She's three now, but I wrote a bunch of songs right after she was born, and this one is for her. This goes out to all the parents making it through quarantine. You can do it. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my sparrow, I'm your tree. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my sparrow, I'm your tree. Hey, little songbird, singing oh so sweet. Your voice is sugar, come on, give me a treat. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my sparrow, I'm your tree. If you be my songbird, I will be your tree. You are the message, I'm the melody. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my sparrow, I'm your tree. Songbird, songbird, I love to hear you sing. You are my wind now, baby, I'm your wing. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my sparrow, I'm your tree. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey, I'm your bee. You're my baby, I'm your mama. You're my honey bee. Well, thank you so much for listening. Again, my name is Dawn Landis. Thank you to Music City Roots for hosting this backyard extravaganza. And hope to be able to play live music for real people. It's been nice playing for the Acorns, but you know, there's nothing like live music. I miss it a lot. So, till the next time we can be in the same space. Here's a song. I'll leave you with this one. It's called Twilight, as the sun is setting. Starless night, another dim street light. If you turn your head just right, the street becomes a sky. And shooting stars go by, they spark and they die. You see the reason why you never catch the night. Ooh. Drags along. Thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful rest of your night, of your day, whenever you're watching this. And I think there's a link to, if you have funds and you care to throw in the tip jar, there's a link down there somewhere. And thanks again to Music City Roots. I love what you guys do, and thanks for supporting live music.